Linda still believed that no one was hurt by us taking what wasn't ours. But when she was arrested and thrown to the floor by a police officer holding a shotgun, all that changed. She felt utterly violated and completely helpless, and finally realised the sheer terror I'd inflicted upon people during all the robberies we'd committed. In July 1986, she stood trial for conspiracy to rob, but her defence lawyer used the usual argument. She'd been forced to become an armed robber against her will. But the judge didn't believe she was a small cog in this operation. You were, in fact, the whole machine. And she was sentenced to 7 years, of which she served three. Around a year after her release, her former partner, Ron Cook, was shot dead in the family home in Plasto while on day release from prison. Linda insisted she was a traumatized bystander, but she was charged with planning a contract killing and hiring a hitman, Danny Reese. The court was told that Danny fired the first shot, but lost his bottle. So Linda had grabbed the sawn-off shotgun herself. She was sentenced to life, in what she describes as a devastating miscarriage of justice. She later married and then divorced Danny Reese, while both were in prison. According to the prosecution, Linda was a woman attractive to and attracted by armed robbers, while to the press, she was the Black Widow, a housewife-turned-executioner whose lovers ended up dead or in jail. Her trial and conviction came against the backdrop of yet another shock rise in female violence. Women were moving into independent criminal operator status in their own right, noted one criminologist, as if this was a new development, while sociologists attributed the problem to greater emancipation. But as had happened in the 1970s, the actual figures told another story, and the reason the gender gap in crime had narrowed was because male offending rates had gone down. Yet fears about violent women continued. Teenage girls were out at night drinking alcopops like hooch, and dreaming of being Lara Croft from Tomb Raider, the computer game that became a feature film with Angelina Jolie, a casual killer in hot pants. The late 1990s also saw the emergence of a new female stereotype, the ladette. She was boisterous, bolshy, boozy, explained Vice, and a product of women's increased equality. Once again, the emancipation of women was posing a serious threat to social order.